because we've talked a lot, Bob, is the team alive? Are they out of this thing? They're three back with 17 to go. But this is interesting. You've got one team out in San Francisco on a 10-game West Coast trip, and you got another team about ready to take on the Mets, Orioles, and Pirates. I don't think you could handpick three better punching bags than those three. And Atlanta's going out west. They got San Francisco, Arizona, and San Diego. So three back, 17 to go. In or out?
Out. Listen, we'll start
by saying. It sounds like that newborn has kept you up too much.
No, I mean, listen, I don't mean to come across as, negative here. I guess it could be interesting the next couple of weeks. But listen, I don't see it. I don't think that there's any reason to trust the Phillies. And I don't think that two wins against the Cubs, is really any reason to feel any differently than I did after they lost four out of five games to begin a homestand against two teams that were, combined almost 50 games under 500 on the road this season. So last night was very impressive the way that they fall behind by seven. They go on and end up blowing out the Cubs, and that's great. Resiliency is wonderful and all of that. But the fact of the matter is that their deficiencies are why they were losing that game 7-0 to begin with. The fact that you're asking guys like J.D. Hammer, who was DFA'd earlier this afternoon, and again, Matt Moore. You talk about Vince Velasquez, and I know how you feel about Vince. That's how I feel when I watch Matt Moore pitch. I mean, the guy just nibbling the corners, walking guys left and right. When he's in the zone, he gets battered. The fact that they're asking this guy to make meaningful pitches in big spots is insane to me right now. So I do not trust this team. I do not believe that even with an advantageous schedule that they are going to catch Atlanta or leapfrog the three teams they'll need to leapfrog in order to win that second wild card spot.
It's interesting. There's a lot to unpack there. I didn't know Hammer got DFA'd. I was making
I shouldn't say DFA'd. I should say he was sent down today.
Okay. Regardless, I mean, they call him up into the bullpen game thing. They've won the last two bullpen, or maybe two out of the last three, I guess. So it hasn't really bit them yet, right?
Yes and no. I mean, because it's so taxing to ask your bullpen to have to take down those types of innings. There can be kind of like a reverberation effect. It's not just that game in isolation. That can have a lasting impact beyond that game. Now, listen, they go to New York this weekend, and they take Zach Wheeler, who'll get the ball tonight, and he's thrown 22 consecutive scoreless innings against the Mets this season. And obviously, you'll recall the last time that he pitched against his former team, he threw a complete game shutout. He was absolutely outstanding, 11 strikeouts. The Phillies have the advantage tonight against Taijuan Walker. They have the advantage, in theory, throwing Aaron Nola up against Carlos Carrasco, and then they finish out the series with Kyle Gibson on Sunday. So they have an opportunity to win this series against the Mets, who, for as miserable as the Phillies are, the Mets are just they're worse. And then they come back, and they have games against the Pirates and Orioles, who are two of the worst teams in baseball. So, when you look at the schedule and you look at the way that things kind of shape up for this team, should they be able to make one last gasp? Sure, especially if Bryce Harper continues to play the way that he has, which in my estimation is like the National League MVP. I guess you can work yourself into saying, yeah, sure, they have a shot. I wouldn't bet on it. I don't believe in this team. I think that they have shown more than enough reason to give doubt.
Yeah, it's interesting because I feel the same way you do. I actually said last week, I said, I think they'll finish under 500. And then I look, I'm like, are you kidding me? They're going to play the Mets. They've got Baltimore and they've got Pittsburgh. And yes, they have struggled against the Arizonas and the Colorados. But, it almost like lines up that you've buried them, put them away. And then Atlanta has got this stretch of games out west where you're like, well, I don't know that they're going to get through this minefield either. I mean, you're rooting for Gabe Kapler to beat the Braves. You've got Vince Velasquez, for God's sakes, pitching in a game that you're kind of rooting for him as well. So, I mean, it's just such an odd scenario that at the end you might say, guess who might just kind of pull out of this?
Yeah, I mean, it is possible. I reached my breaking point with the giving the benefit of the doubt earlier this week with the first loss to the Cubs, though. I wrote a column today, and basically – I said it's impossible to watch the Phillies and not think about the idea of what if with this team. But you can excuse all of their failings and all of their shortcomings up until as recently as this last homestand. And if they simply would have gone 3-2 at the start of it rather than 1-4 against the Rockies and the Cubs, you're talking about a team that would have an opportunity by the end of the night to be holding down a playoff spot, whether it be tied for the NL East lead or leading the wild card. But they couldn't even manage that, even with everything stacked so favorably in front of them. And so I just don't know how you can look at this and say, oh, the Pirates, the Orioles, and oh, the Braves schedule's a little harder right now, and think, yeah, they're going to run this team down. I just don't think you can do it.
I'm like so in step with what you're saying. I just feel like, my gosh, you know, you can't, like, you've lost to Colorado, you've lost to Arizona. Can you continue to keep losing to the dreck of the league? Like, at some point, you've got to turn around and be like, all right, we're going to hand. They play four against some one of the two, Baltimore or Pittsburgh. They have four against. I'm imagining Pittsburgh. I don't think you'll play a four-game set against an American League team. But it's like, at some point, the losses against these terrible teams, you've got to kind of even them back out, right?
Yeah, and listen, I think that if they are going to win the wild card, and you consider just the volume of teams that remain in the mix there, they're probably going to have to go 8-10 over the next 10 games between the Mets, the Pirates, and the Orioles. I would think that 8-2 over a 10-game stretch would probably give you an opportunity to realistically win the wild card.
Okay.
In order to kind of stick around and make that series in Atlanta a little bit more meaningful or to make it interesting, I think that they're probably going to have to win 6 or 7 games out of the next 10 to give themselves a shot playing Atlanta head up. You know, can they do that? Should they do that? Sure. It really does start this weekend, though. You know, you can't go out and get swept by the Mets. You can't lose this series to the Mets. In fact, I think really to kind of offset some of the damage that you did, some of the self-inflicted wounds of this past homestand, you probably have to sweep the Mets. And I don't know. That feels like a big ask for a team that struggles the way that they do on the road. That being said, one thing I do want to hit on is just, you know, what Bryce Harper has done.
Yeah.
And I think that, you know, it's not a stretch to say, and I know that Fernando Tatis Jr. is still the betting favorite to win the MVP. But when you just look at Bryce Harper's numbers across the board, and you know about the OPS, and he's starting to compile some RBI numbers now, the power numbers are creeping into the mid-30s here. I read this earlier. Kenny Ayers, one of the Phillies PR guys, sent it out in an email. There are four players since the invention of the All-Star game, the advent of the All-Star game back in 1933, that have an OPS as high as Bryce Harper's in the second half of this season, which is 1255. And it's Barry Bonds, it's Ted Williams, it's Albert Bell, and Ryan Howard. Those are the only four players that have a 1255 OPS or higher post All-Star break over the last 90 years. And so what he's doing right now is just absolutely outstanding. And it's a shame that it's coming in what I think is going to be a lost season.
Yeah, I know it's I think Matt Gelb wrote about, hey, you're going to waste an MVP-type season. And one of these 13 years, I mean, you can't say he's going to win multiple MVPs. You would think if you get one or two and to not make the playoffs would be a shame. You wrote about, like, if only. How is Dave – you said, like, it's hard to not watch and think, if only. How is Dave Dombrowski watching these games?
I think that Dave Dombrowski looks at this and says, this team wasn't very good. Like, we didn't think that this was a 90-win team. We didn't expect it to win the division. We thought if things would break right, maybe we could get in. You know, he's talked multiple times about the weakness of the NL East and the way that things kind of materialized. But I don't think that he entered this year with a great deal of urgency to make this team that immediate contender and have them make a postseason run. I really think that this was always a two-year plan. I know I've said this on your show before. I don't mean to belabor the point. But I really do think that this is an evaluation period in which he wanted to try to make this team as competitive as possible, perhaps secure a playoff spot in the process. But I don't think that this season has really gone, when you look at the Phillies specifically, much differently than the way that they probably expected internally. Now, obviously, missing the playoffs in such a weak division, if the Braves would have won 94 games, it would be different. But the Braves are vulnerable, right? And so I think the Phillies probably expected to be in this race kind of down the stretch, but the fact that they were just gifted this opportunity and haven't really been able to take advantage of it has to be very frustrating.
Very frustrating.
I really think that this team this offseason is going to try to hit that next gear. I really think that they're going to spend a little bit more. They're going to be a little bit more aggressive. And I think that it really is about 2022 and going for broke. I think that there is urgency in that organization. I think there are people that are just absolutely tired of being an afterthought come mid-September.
Yeah, I mean, you see the attendance, about 16,000. So it seems that the fans have tapped out on this team. And that has to be frustrating, too, because, Bob, I think we talked about, like, they were in the race the last couple of years. They don't have anybody to watch. You go out and get Bryce Harper, who might be the MVP of the league, and you're still not coming out. That says, if you're not winning and we don't believe in you, we're not coming unless you are definitively for real.
Yeah, there's no reason the fans should invest their – I can't tell fans what they should and should not do, but I should say I do not blame fans for not investing their time in person, their money at the ballpark to watch that product. It's just not a very inspiring product, and, you know, they, I guess, have an opportunity to change that if they come out and have a hell of a 2 weeks here. You know, you'll watch this fan base jump on real quick, you know, but up until this point, I just don't think that there's really any reason to truly believe in them, and I just – you know, this fan base is smart enough to know what's real and what's not, and I think they've sized this team up pretty well here.
We got 17 left, 3 back, Phillies and the Mets this weekend. Atlanta is out in San Francisco. They'll then go to Arizona for 4, and then 3 in San Diego. So keep your eye on both the wild card and the NL East, and of course, we will do the same. Bob Wankel crossing broad, 3 games back behind the Braves. When they play the Braves in 10 games from now, where will they be? 3? You're saying 3?
I'll have them 2 games out in Atlanta, and then the Braves finish them off in that series is kind of where I'm at.
All right. Bob Wankel crossing broad. Zach Wheeler tonight, by the way. I got the Phillies lineup. Did you see the lineup? It was out a while ago, but have you seen it
yet? I did see the lineup, yeah.
Herrera, Segura, Harper, Realmuto, DD, Galvis, Miller, Vierling, and Wheeler. There you go. That's what they're going with, trying to win a game against the Mets. All right, man. We'll talk to you, pal.
Talk to you soon.